lattice enthalpy. So the lattice enthalpy of an ionic solid is defined as the energy required to completely separate one mole of solid ionic compound into gaseous constituent ion. So what is lattice enthalpy? Enthalpy means heat. I've already explained you this thing in previous class. Enthalpy means heat. Lattice matlab your crystal lattice, your ionic crystal lattice. So that amount of energy which is required to separate one mole of solid means to separate solid components into a gaseous ion. For example, the lattice enthalpy of NaCl. The best example of crystal lattice is NaCl. NaCl is common salt, which we use to eat in our daily life. Okay, so common salt is NaCl, sodium chloride, is 788 kilojoule per mole. Take a kilojoule mole. So this means that 788 kilojoule of energy is required to separate one mole of solid NaCl into one mole of Na positive or one mole of Cl negative at infinite distance. Got it? If you want to break the bond between the Na positive and Cl negative, it means we required at least 788 kilojoule energy. And this energy is known as the lattice enthalpy. All right? Enthalpy is heat. Next, let us talk about other things which are related to the structure of atoms, that is bond parameters. Means the bond parameters are like the things or the properties which are related to bonds. It can be ionic covalent, any bond. So the things which are related to the bonds, that is first bone length. Bone length is defined as the equilibrium distance between the nucleus of two bones of atom in a molecule. If you want to find out the bone length, that what is the bone length of any, means what is the bone length in any molecule? So it is the distance between the two nucleuses, means nucleuses of both the combining atoms that constitutes the bone length. All right, from one nucleus to another nucleus, you can calculate the length of that bond, okay? So, in the case of covalent bond, the contribution from each atom is called the covalent radii. So, the bond length, or you can say, the covalent means all the element, means each and every element contributes contribute each bond that is known as the covalent radii. The covalent radii is the measure of approximately as the radius of atom core which is contact with the core of the adjacent atom in a bonded situation. So what is covalent radii? It is just a measure between the two cores of means from one nucleus to another nucleus, to the adjacent atom's nucleus, that constitutes the total covalent radii. The covalent radius is half of the distance between two similar atoms joined by the covalent bond of the same molecules. The Van der Waals radius represents the overall size of the atom, which includes its valency shell in the known bonding situation. So let us talk about the total bond length. Since these are the two atoms, these are the two ions, cation and anion, since there is a difference in the size. So what is that? Okay, one is accepting the electron, another one is donating the electron, and they shared or they shared the electron. It means the main focus or main emphasis is that they are combining with the force of attraction. Okay? If you want to calculate the bone length, so it means bone length means from length is when we start measuring something from one point and end it at another point. So if I start measuring from A point, the center of the nucleus, to the B point, the center of the another nucleus of the atom. So this entire length is known as the bone length. And if someone asks you, then what is the radius? What is the covalent radius or what is the ionic radius? Means what is the radius of that bone which they are sharing? So at that point of time, you just divide it with the two. Just make it half. All right. So half of that will be considered as covalent radius. Why this is known as covalent radius? Because they are sharing their electron and forming covalent bond. So the bond which is found at that point of time is covalent bond. So that is why that is known as the covalent radii. If we talk about the atoms, normal atom size, so at that point of time, that is known as atomic radii, ionic radii. That means property will be same, but name change according to the formation of bond between the elements. If ionic bond is there at that time, that will be called as ionic radii. If covalent bond is there, then at that time, that will be known as covalent radii. Okay, radius and radii are same thing. Radii is the singular. Next is bond length, bond angle. Bond angle is what? What is bond angle? The angle between the bonded species. All right, yeah, you can say the angle between the two bonds. Listen, as we have seen in the Lewis dot structures, that he dotted electrons at the side. Means, for example, now these two lone pair of electrons are apart from each other. Why we can't place these two with these four electrons together? Why these hydrogen cannot place together? Because of the same charge. Since these two electrons and these electrons are negatively charged, and when we just, you know, when they come in close to each other, they experience a repulsive force. All right, and that because of the same charge, we know same charges repel each other. So at that time, they just take a position around the atom where they feel minimum repulsion and maximum stability. So this is the reason they are apart from at an angle. There is an angle between their apartments. This is about the lone pair electrons. Let us talk about the bond pair electrons. Bond pair means which participate in the bond. So bond pair electrons also means experience force of repulsion from each other. So if we talk about this hydrogen, which is present at the left side, so the bond pair electron experience repulsion from lone pair electron and as well as this bond pair electron. All right. So they will take a place where they feel or experience minimum repulsion and maximum stability. So that will be at 109.5 degrees Celsius. So this is actually that place, or you can say this is that position where they experience least repulsion from each other. All right. So that they will not come closer to each other, or they will not move far from each other. So this is the structure of water molecule in which oxygen has four lone pair electrons and two bond pair electrons, which are shared with the hydrogen. So it is defined as the angle between the containing bonded electron pairs around the central atom in a molecule or complex ion. It gives some idea regarding the distribution of orbital around the central atom in a molecule or complex ion. Has it help us in determining the shape? So because of this, we will be able to find out that what will be the shape of the molecule. Okay, shapes we will learn when we'll go down to the chapter, that how you will predict that what is the shape of this molecule. And if you want to know the shape, then you have to consider only bond pair electron. In shapes, we don't consider lone pair electron. We consider only the bond pair electrons. They predict the shape. So for example, this HOH means H2O bond angle in water can be represented by like this. So generally, if you just write the skeleton of the water molecule, so we will write like this, H bond O bond S. So this is a normal representation. But when we talk about the shape, angle, and structure, at that point of time, you have to draw this diagram. So this is the shape of a water molecule. All right. Next, we'll talk about the bond enthalpy. Bond enthalpy means, enthalpy is, I've already mentioned H, the symbol for enthalpy is H, and delta is the change in enthalpy, and A shows the bond enthalpy here. So it is the amount of energy required to break one mole of bond of a particular type between two atoms in a gaseous state. The unit of bond enthalpy is kilogram per mole. So this is a bond enthalpy. द अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी टू रिक्वायर टू ब्रेक अ बॉन्ड ओके बिटवीन द टू एटम्स सो दैट इज नोन एज बॉन्ड एंथैल्पी मीन्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट तो वॉट इज बॉइलिंग पॉइंट द पॉइंट एट विच द बॉन्ड बिटवीन द एटम्स ऑफ दैट लिक्विड ब्रेक है ना एंड दैट योर लिक्विड स्टार्ट मूविंग इन टू द गैसियस स्टेट दैट इज नोन एज बॉइलिंग पॉइंट सो सेम the bond that exists between the elements so the amount of heat which is required to break that bond is known as bond enthalpy so for example for every molecule some amount of energy or bond enthalpy is not needed to break same amount of energy is we it's not actually like same for each and every element or compound or molecule it bond enthalpy actually differs depend on the type of bond depend on the number of bonds means for example if single bond is there so we require less amount of energy as compared to break the bond between the multiple means the multiple bonds okay so needed to break the atom therefore different bond enthalpies are needed in polyatomic molecules polyatomic molecule means poly means many many when many atoms combine together and form a molecule In terms means or average bond enthalpy is used. So at the time, for example, if I talk about H2SO4, hydrogen is there, oxygen is there, sulfur is there. Along with that, we have different numbers. Two hydrogen, one sulfur, oxygen 4. So this is a polyatomic molecule. So in that, we require different bond enthalpy to break the bond of hydrogen and sulfur. Different enthalpies needed to break the bond between the oxygen and sulfur. So at that time, we used to take the average of all the enthalpies and then calculate. So that enthalpy is known as what? The bond dissociation enthalpy or bond enthalpy. Same point is there, same word is there. Bond enthalpy is the amount of energy to break the bond. And another name for this is the bond dissociation enthalpy, the amount of energy required to dissociate a bond, to break a bond. Same, only words are different. Definition and meaning is same. All right. Let us talk about bond order. What is bond order? In the Lewis description of the covalent bond, the bond order is given by the number of bond between the two atoms in a molecule. Beta means mark this point or write this point anywhere in your notebook that the bond order, what is bond order? It is the number of bond between the two atoms. And we have a separate formula to calculate it. That how you can calculate that one number of bonds which are present in that specific molecules. So the bond order, for example, H2. If we talk about the hydrogen molecules with a single shared electron pair, it means number of bond in H2 is 1. If we talk about O2 with two shared pair of electrons, it means it shares two electrons and form two bond, double bonds. Let us talk about N2. They share three electron pairs. Three from one nitrogen electrons and three electrons from another nitrogen. And they form three electron pairs. So the bond order will be 3. Okay. So bond order tells us about the number of bonds which are present in that specific molecule. So nitrogen in the bond order of nitrogen is 1, oxygen is 2, and 3 for nitrogen. All right. In isoelectronic molecules and ions have identical bond order. So if we talk about the ions, so they can have identical bond order, similar bond order. Even they in normal state or in gaseous state, they show different bond order, but in ionic state, they show similar. So for example, F2 and O2 2 negative have bond order 1. Okay. N2 carbon monoxide and NO have bond order 3. A general correlation useful for understanding the stability of the molecule is that with increase in bond order, bond enthalpy increases, the bond length decreases. So what happened when you relate all those three things, whenever there is an increase in bond order and bond enthalpy, it led to decrease in the bone length. For example, why bone length? If, for example, if I am tying my hands with a single rope, okay, so I can stretch them long, all right? So at that point of time, the bone length will be large. But if I tie my hand with two bends, two ropes, so it just restrict my motion, which led to reduce in bone length. If I take one more rope to tie my hands, so that completely restricts the motion, which ultimately reduces the bone length. All right.